as we have Force Knight in the black armor up against Ice Shadow in the white and blue. Ice Shadow's been flipped over. He's trying to stealth right. The carnage is supreme. Oh!
Hey there, Builder Blog. This is a question we get all the time. Parents buy a robot starter kit for their kids, they go to their very first competition, and the robot gets wrecked. And the question is, what do you do? Well, now it's time to be a robot builder and an engineer and repair your robot. And so I invited from the Nexus Knockout the Indigo League team to bring their two robots down. This was, I believe, either this student's first or second competition, and both of his plastic ant weights got trashed. So he's brought them to my shop, and I'm going to walk him and his mom through what it's going to take to get these two robots ready for their next competition, which is next week. So let's cut on over and see what we can do to fix some bots.
So I'm Indigo Lee. I am, it's like the color, so, and we built these foodish bots, you know?
My name is Melissa. We are a mother-son duo. He likes to say I'm the engineer and he's the person that drives.
So I know you guys just got back from Bunny's Nexus event, and it looks like your two robots took some damage. Do you mind going over what happened to them?
So you can see right here, it just split right here. And we were using a gyroid info, but I think because of the way it printed, it just split right there.
So the big thing we have to fix on this guy is we've got a damaged print. And then what happened to this one?
This one used to have two armors. And now it only has one. We took a really hard hit here because we had a short screw.
Oh no!
And now we need to replace the frame. Also, one of our wheels died.
All right. Well, let's start with Pizza Bot, and then we can tear into the Ice Robot too to see what's going on. All right, Builder Blog. We have two ways we're going to try to fix this. One, usually when a 3D print breaks, most people just print a new one, which is an option. But today we're going to try something a little different on the blog. We got this goop at the open source event, specifically for PLA, and we're going to see if we can manage to put this back together with a little bit of magic. Let's give it a try.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've started by dismounting the pizza wedge, and now we have the damaged 3D printed part here. I've gone ahead and I disconnected some of the wires so we can get to just this part. I've prepped a clamp, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to cover this in goop, and then I'm going to use the clamp to add pressure to keep everything sitting in the right location. So let's see if we can pull this off. So this comes out with a brush, and it's very goopy. It lives up to its name. We're going to try to coat the damaged surfaces in it. I'm not sure exactly how much to use, so I'm going to assume a plentiful amount.
So Builder Blog, I'm going to speed this part up. We did go ahead, put goop on this. We let it dry for 24 hours, and the report back I got from Mr. Lee was this actually did not hold up. It broke in the exact same spot in his next match. So this goop trick is really nice if you get your robot damaged and you just want to put it back together to stick it on a shelf as like a, to remember the robot as it was, not what happened to it. But I would not actually recommend this for combat. Go ahead and just replace the frame and print a new one.
All right, so I'm going to show you one of my master level tricks here. This is DevCom flowable silicone. I get this at Orchard Supply. And this is, after testing a lot of different ones, this is my favorite one. But I know there is much debate on Reddit and the forum of which is the best. But this is my favorite. Okay. So we're going to silicone your wheels. And this instantly doubles the traction of FingerTech foam wheels. So you can do this to any of the Witch Doctor kits. You can do this to the FingerTech Viper kit. And I want to show you how you do it right now. So we have powered on your robot, and we can do this while we wait for the goop to dry. And remember these trim switches on your radio, how you turn it on and then the robot drives without you? We're going to use that right now.
Okay.
So We have just a little leftover piece of polycarb or bulletproof glass. You can use like a business card or anything, but we're going to goop on some of this flowable silicone. Just imagine it's coming out where it's supposed to, as opposed to the hole I punctured in this. But once you get it spread around there, go ahead and put the trim off. There we go. I use one hand to make sure the robot doesn't fall over. You could also do that by putting in the vise, but then use the other piece to just spread it out. This actually helps make your wheels a little rounder too.
It also looks satisfying.
And when you're all done, you find that magical spot again, and you have a wheel. You have to let this dry for 24 hours. If you go try to fight right now, you're just gonna smear silicone on the floor. So this does need to be done the night before a competition. You can't do this day of. Okay. That's something everybody gets wrong.
Yeah.
And a heat gun gets it a little drier, but not dry enough to fight. Made it look easy. Though when you try to do it yourself, you are going to get your hands covered in silicone. So I might have to go do a few more robots tonight since I accidentally punctured this tube. But now I say we set this robot aside. We're going to let the goop dry on the shattered part of the 3D print, and we're going to let the silicone dry. And then we will come back. And we should also put that battery on the shirt.
Okay, new battery.
All right, quick interruption. I got to get some builder blog stuff out. So, next week, you're not going to see me. In fact, you're not going to see me for the next 2 weeks. Next week is BattleBots Face Off Week 7. 7, I can count. Minotaur is taking on free shipping. Not Slammo. He's in the final week. He's also recording for us later this month. But Minotaur, free shipping, the big deal, the biggest deal, and everyone's favorite speed demon, Claw Viper. They're all facing off this weekend at BattleBots Face Off, and the big deal team has agreed to record for us. So we will have a man in the field, and you're going to have an eye from the pits. So please like and subscribe. That video is coming up next week. I know you guys can't wait for it. I can't wait for it. And we actually have two videos without me, with guest hosts. The week after that, Josh, he went all the way to South Korea to compete in the IRC, the International Robot Competition. They invite champions from all the different countries to all come to South Korea for a glorious one-pound competition. And he sent me over 45 minutes of footage. I'm going to try to get that pared down to about 30. And it's going to be an epic, epic episode in 2 weeks. You guys are not going to want to miss it. So once again, please like and subscribe to the Skorpios Builder Blog so you don't miss any of this. And let's get back to it because we got another robot to fix.
Thank you, Big Dylan Calypso.
I've lost a gearbox on this tire, I think. And then we lost like this thing, so it's kind of tilted down.
So I think we're missing a bearing here. Yeah. We have a broken gearbox here, and we need a new upright so you can screw a new piece of armor here. All right. So a well-defined problem is half solved. And we've just defined our three problems.
Yep.
Missing bearing, broken gearbox, new upright. Let's see what we can do to get these three things fixed.
All right. We've gone through and we've taken out all of the screws. So now it's time to pull this guy apart. So we're gonna take off our top plates, take out the battery cover, and now we're gonna see if we can get the damaged upright out of the robot. So pulling up, and there we go. So now we can try to find,
That melted a little bit. We could try to find our missing bearing, and we can replace our motor. So
it felt like a dead gearbox because you get that crunchy motion. However, if you follow the gear line, what's rotating and what isn't rotating, you can actually see all the gears still rotate until it gets to that little tiny pinion that I am struggling to get the phone to focus on. That pinion gear at the very bottom is out of line. And that means the shaft inside the motor is tweaked. And if we look on the very back, this back piece started to peel off and the shaft came out and ground on one side. So normally I would just replace the gearbox, but this time we have a good gearbox and a bad motor. So we're actually gonna replace the whole thing, but we are going to save this gearbox for when we do break a shaft off a gearbox for next time.
So you've tinned both motor leads.
So I've gone ahead and I've applied solder to both of these, tinning it. And I made sure to check this before we took it off. We had the black wire on negative and the positive wire was red. Now, looks like you have a little bit of length left. I'm gonna redo these a bit. So, I tried to twist these together before soldering, and I know it seems excessive, but you tend to get little straggler hairs like this, and it starts coming apart on you.
Yeah.
But if you do a twist before you do the solder, you actually get a much better result, and it stays together as you solder it on and off.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're doing repairs mid-fight, that's actually really important. And then when soldering cabling like this, I know a lot of people like a third hand. This is the little squeezy tool I like to use. These are pliers that stay closed naturally. You want to start by putting a little solder on the iron and put it underneath. You then feed solder from the top. And what you're trying to do is you want to heat the whole wire so the solder actually penetrates everything. So once again, a little solder on the iron, put that underneath, and then solder from the top. And it doesn't instantly go. It takes a second because it's heating up the wire. But once the wire heats, you get full penetration, and that covers all of it, so it won't start fraying on you. Now that we've tinned the motor tab and tinned the wire, we go ahead and do our attachment. And I put them side by side, and then just a little bit of heat. Give it a second. Once again, put them side by side. Give it a little bit of heat. A little too much solder. And there we go. That is a good connection. And the last thing you should always do, violently shake it. If it's gonna break, you want it to break right now so you can fix it. Now obviously don't pull this so hard you rip the motor apart, but you do want to make a check and make sure that's actually attached. All right, so right now this hole is pretty damaged. Unfortunately, it was rubbing on the inside of this piece doing this, and it has walked this hole open. Now, I would highly recommend 3D printing this, but if you are truly in a pinch, say you are at a tournament, the bearing does at least seat center. And I know that because if you look directly down, you can see it's right over the motor shaft. Unfortunately, it does not press in at all. But what we're gonna try to do is put a ring of hot glue and then try to get it to this location. This is what I would call a combat fix. This is something you would only really consider doing if you were at a tournament and you had to get it done. And we're gonna do this to try to salvage this weapon, but I would highly recommend getting a spare bearing, getting a spare motor, and printing a spare weapon, because this will probably only last one, maybe two more fights. All right. So, unfortunately, we've melted around this nut, and we need the nut. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna back this out, and then with that sticking out on this side, I'm gonna try to see if I can force through that plastic. If that doesn't work, get a little leverage.
And if that doesn't work, get a little hammer. And just like that, we got the nut and bolt free. See, now that this is a dead robot part that's broken here and broken here, this is the part where you autograph it and hand it to your biggest fan.
Okay.
Hand it over.
Aww,
thank you.
So I'm trying to make sure nothing gets into the inner race. Because we're trying. Oh god, that was bad. Little stringers. Stringers I can live with. And I'm trying to pack some in around the race. As I just slowly work my way around. This is not how I'd recommend fixing this long term, but like I said, this is kind of like a field repair. Of, you have a pit runner standing over you going, I need you in the arena in 10 minutes or you forfeit! And this is the kind of thing you would do. So then, let's get those little stringers off. Let that cool for a second and make sure we're still centered to that motor inside, which it is. And we've managed to put the bearing back in the weapon.
Wait for the hot glue to dry. We're trying to get the armor plate in. But this is really too tight. Very too tight. Like, I'm gonna break something else. Oh my god, I might have gotten this stuck. Whoops. Wow. Okay, don't record my shame. All right. So this is a tool I really love. This is called a tri-file. Instead of being flat or being four sides, this is literally a triangle shape. And it's really handy for these grooved surfaces. What we're gonna do is we're just gonna sand this just a little bit to hopefully make it so this armor piece can slot in easier. Files only cut going forward. That's a little known fact. And so if you run back and forth like this with the file, you actually wear it out and it'll stop working. But a nice fresh file, if you move only forward with it, you'd be amazed how well and how long that file is going to work for you. But hopefully if we just hit these edges a little bit, we'll be able to get this part to slot in a lot easier. And I am slightly tilting it up to press into the T-slot, which is what you would call this feature. And you can see there's even some material up here. And another awesome tool if you want the powered version of this. So Orion Beach from Hijinks is the one who first showed me this. It's a little tiny belt sander. And if you just basically want oh wow, that's way too effective. Well, I definitely sanded that part down. This is another tool that's easy to bring with you to the pit area. You don't have to find power or a plug for it. And it is adjustable to help you get into even the tiniest little spaces. I have to admit, this has saved me many times. And it's great for sharpening wedges. So now let's see if this fits any better. Hey, it clicks in. There we go.
So much better.
So now that we got your bearing set back in here, and don't worry, we only got a little bit of debris from my bench in it. Mm-hmm. We're gonna put your new rail on that we got the parts salvaged from the old rail, and we're gonna press this into your robot.
And hope it works.
Yes. Pray to the robot gods.
just like that. And now we get to go put a bunch of screws in your robot.
Yeah.
I'm going on break. It's your turn.
Okay.
And I do want to take this moment to remind parents to try to make your kids do as many of these steps as possible. Now, obviously, with the power tools and the soldering iron, I would recommend doing that step for them. However, make sure they're there and they're watching. They see that everyone's wearing safety glasses and how it is done. But anytime you can step aside to make sure they get their hands in the robot, I would do that as much as possible. So, what did you learn at this last competition? Because that is the most important question.
This thing has a very hard turn.
So that's actually from the gyroscope in your weapon. And one thing I want you to try next time you're in an arena, try spinning your weapon at only half speed while you're trying to line up to your opponent.
Okay.
And then peg it right before you go for the big hit.
Okay. That's good advice.
What else did you learn? You had two robots. I expect at least two lessons. Two lessons learned. What else you got?
This weapon has pretty good impact. I don't know.
So, one of the things I always try to do at the end of each tournament is I try to look at my robots and think about the things I'm fixing and what could I have done differently so that doesn't happen next time. So let's look at your pizza robot. Let's come over here. Point out to me what broke on the pizza robot.
This needs to be stronger because it broke off from impact.
Okay. Now, due to the magic of editing, I'm going to play your match right here. What ripped off your weapon?
Impact. Just impact.
Was it a horizontal spinner?
Drum.
Yes. Oh, yeah, that's right. You were fighting a drum. So, what could you try differently as opposed to ramming your pizza slice into the drum?
Try to go back for the back or the sides, probably.
That's true. And that's the easy thing. Or I should say, that's the hard thing to do that's easy to say.
That's true.
I would recommend, especially for lifter robots, when you're fighting a kinetic energy like that, lift your weapon up and ram them with the body of your robot.
And then
wait to use your weapon until you've already slowed down their weapon or stalled their weapon. Because once it comes to a stall, it's great to have it. You can either slap them on the top with it, whack, whack, whack. Or if the drum has come to a stop, you could put it down and then try to flip them over.
Yeah.
So that's going to be my last piece of advice to you. Okay. I want you to really think about what broke on your robot and what could you do to have that not happen next time. Okay. And that's the biggest thing at the end of each tournament to learn.
Why a builder blog?
Hey, Zach, how many ears does Captain Picard have?
Two?
Three. He has his right ear, his left ear, and the final frontier.
Oh.